फेवरेट क्लास 10 साइंस चैप्टर 11 दैट इज द ह्यूमन आई एंड द कलरफुल वर्ल्ड। ह्यूमन आई व्हाटएवर वी सी ऑल अराउंड अस वी सी मेनी थिंग्स वंडरफुल वर्ल्ड द कलरफुल वर्ल्ड एंड वी सी ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ आवर आईज। आई इट इज वेरी सेंसिटिव पार्ट आउट ऑफ five sensor guns, one of this five sensor gun that is eye, and eye enables us to see different things. When we open our eyes, we can see what's present around us. But when we close our eye, then we can identify some things by our skin and touching. By smelling with our nose, by hearing some sounds, or by tasting with our tongue. But some specified substances can be identified. But when we open our eyes, we can see everything. In light, in the presence of light, we can see everything. So, this eye is very sensitive here. The eye is very important. This eye always helps to see every substance. This eye is like a camera. When the camera captures the image of any object. Similarly, we can see eyes. It can capture the image of eye. When we see any substance, any things which is present in front of us, then image of that substance will be captured by refraction through the iris and it forms the image. So let's discuss about the parts of human eye. It is human eye. Here, this human eye is spherical in shape. It is roughly spherical. This one is called eyeball. Eyeball. It's roughly spherical with diameter 2.3 cm approximately. The front part there is cornea, and most of the light is refracted through this cornea. This cornea refracts most of the light which falls on it. After the refraction of light through cornea, it passes through the lens. That is called eye lens, which is crystalline nature. So it is called crystalline lens. It is iris, cornea, it is iris, this one is ciliary muscles, it is retina, the liquid present here is aqueous humor, the liquid present here is called vitreous humor, this one is optic nerve. First, cornea, which is present the outside of the eye, and it is transparent in nature. This cornea refracts most of the light, and this light comes into the eye through this eye lens. When light enters here, this light is controlled by the iris regulates the gap between them. This gap is called pupil. If the size of pupil is small, then less amount of light will enter. If the size of pupil is more, then more amount of light will enter here. So this size of pupil is controlled by, regulated by iris. Size of pupil is regulated by iris. When light enters through this pupil and comes to iris, then it passes through the iris. Iris is in convex nature. It is convex form. And it acts as a convex lens. When light is refracted through this convex lens, then it forms the image at retina. At retina, the image will form, and this image is real and inverted. After the formation of image on the retina, the image will be converted into electrical signal by light sensitive cells present on the retina, that is rods and cones. And the image which is converted into electrical signal will be carried by optic nerves to the brain, and brain interpret the image. In this way we can identify. So here they are present some semi-liquid in between cornea and iris. That is called aqueous humor. Here semi-liquid is there in between, or the space between cornea and iris. That is called aqueous humor. It helps the cornea in working state. With the presence of this aqueous humor, the cornea is in bulging structure, and also this aqueous humor provides nutrition to the cells of this cornea. Next, a semi-liquid is present inside the eyeball. This eyeball contains a semi-liquid, that is called vitreous humor. Due to the presence of vitreous humor, the eyeball is in spherical shape. Next, ciliary muscles. This eyelens is kept in its proper position by ciliary muscles. A type of muscles present here, that is ciliary muscles. These ciliary muscles also help to change the focal length of the eyelens. When the focal length of eyelens will be changed, then we can focus the substances which are present near and some distance from us. We can focus every substance which is present near us or far. Due to the presence of this ciliary muscles, it will shrink or it will expand or relax according to the expansion and relaxation. The curvature of this eyelens will be changed. That's why the focal length of the lens will be changed. After changing the focal length, we can focus at the object. Here, the iris, which is a color diaphragm, it is a dark muscular structure which gives color to the eye. All of you see, some of the persons have blue eyes, some have black eyes, some have brown eyes. That depends upon the color of iris. If the color of iris is blue, then the eye appears as blue. If the color of iris is brown, then eye of the person becomes brown. According to the color of iris, the color of eyes will be appear. Next, on the retina, there present some light sensitive cells, that is rods and cones. These are two types of light sensitive cells, rods and cones. Rods are activated on bright light, and cones are activated on dim light. Rods are activated in bright light, cones are activated in dim light. When or during the daytime, we can see the object here, but in dim light or in night, we can't see because we have not such amount of that light sensitive cone, light sensitive cells. But in the link of this optic nerve and retina, a region is there where light sensitive cells are absent. If light sensitive cells are absent there and image forms on this part, the image will not be converted into electrical signal. It will not be carried by optic nerve. So image will not reach our brain. That's why we can't see the object even if the object is present in front of us. Sometimes we feel even if object is present in front of us, then also we can't see that. It is due to the image formation at the region where light sensitive cells are absent. And this region is called blind spot. That is called blind spot. Another region also present where maximum amount of light sensitive cells are present there. Here, maximum amount of light sensitive cells are present at a region. And when image comes at that region, more information can be carried by this optic nerve to the brain. So we can see very clearly that region is called yellow spot. Blind spot and yellow spot. Blind spot means where, or the region where no light sensitive cells are present, and yellow spot means the region where maximum light sensitive cells are present. Next, when we touch our eyes, we feel it is slightly harder. That is due to the presence of cilia, an opaque structure which is opaque for light. It is present all around this eyeball except the cornea. Cornea is not covered by cilia because it is opaque. If it is covered, light can't enter it. So, except this cornea, other parts are covered by cilia, which provides toughness to the eye. Next, we will discuss about the defects of vision and their correction. Defects of vision. Sometimes we see some persons can see distant object, but they can't see the object present nearby. And some persons, they feel easy or they see clearly which are present near them but can't see the distance which is present far. But some persons, like in persons in old age, neither they can see nearby objects but can see the far object. That is due to the defects of their vision. So, what are these defects and how it will be corrected? We'll discuss about it. First one is myopia. That is the short-sightedness. Myopia, short-sightedness. When a person suffering from myopia, then that person can see nearby objects clearly, but can't see distant object clearly. A person can see nearby objects clearly, but कांट से डिस्टेंट ऑब्जेक्ट किया है क्या द सिम्टम्स ऑफ दिस डिफेक्ट्स पार्सन कैन सी नियर बाय ऑब्जेक्ट्स क्लियरली बट कांट सी distant object clearly. The person can see nearby objects clearly, but can't see distant object clearly. So we know the person is suffering from myopia. How a person suffers from this short-sightedness? Why? The person suffer from myopia. There present two reasons. First one, that reason for happening myopia. First, elongation of eyeball. When the eyeball is elongated. When the eyeball is elongated, length of eyeball is increased, then the person will suffer from myopia. Next, if the focal length of eye lens is decreased, focal length of eye lens is decreased. First one is elongation of eyeball. Second one is focal length of eye lens is decreased. If the focal length is decreased, then image will form in front of the retina. If image forms in front of retina, then no light sensitive cells like rods and cones are present there. The image will not be converted into electrical signal and will not be carried by optic nerves to the brain. So we can't see that object. When the converting power of eye lens is increased, if the converting power of eye lens is increased, then the ray will converge very soon. That's why the focal length is decreased. After converge in front of the retina, the focal length will decrease there. In that case, the person will suffer from myopia. How this defect of eye will be corrected when a person suffers from myopia? How this defect will be corrected? That is correction. By using concave lens of suitable power. If a person suffers from myopia and he uses any concave lens with suitable power according to the converging nature of the eye lens, the concave lens is used, then the image again forms on the retina of the eye lens, by which the person will be corrected from myopia. The person who is suffering from myopia will be corrected. He can see again the distant object. The myopia is corrected by using this concave lens. So what will be the ray diagram when a person suffering from myopia at when it is used concave lens there? Check. This one is the islands where light enters the eye. They will converge in front of the retina. Here, this one is myopic eye. When a parallel beam of light is coming from the object, when it enters and is refracted by islands, then both the refracted rays meet in front of the retina. So image comes here. Since image comes here, it will not be carried by optic nerve. This image will not be converted into electrical signal because no light sensitive cells are present there. So this object cannot be identified by the person. The person can't see that distant object. Next, when it is used for gaze lens, concave lens is used and if a parallel beam of light is coming here, the ray will divert by passing through this concave lens. Since it is diverging lens, so rays will divert after passing through this convex lens again, they again converge at the retina. So they come. Refracted rays are meeting on the retina, image will come here. Since image comes on the retina, it will be converted into electrical signal by light sensitive cells and carried by optic nerves to the brain. We can see the object now. It is corrected now. This one is myopic eye, this one is corrected eye. In myopic eye, refracted rays meet in front of retina, but in corrected eye, refracted rays meet on the retina. Discuss about hypermetropia, that is one lung sightedness. Hypermetropia, that is called farsightedness or nonsightedness. Some persons, they can see distant object clearly but can't see nearby objects clearly. Such type of defect is called hypermetropia. The person suffering from hypermetropia can see distant object clearly but can't see nearby objects. If a person can see distant object very clearly but unable to see the nearby objects clearly, then we say the person is suffering from farsightedness or hypermetropia. It is also two reasons just opposite to that of the myopia. First one, In myopia, the eyeball is elongated, but in hypermetropia, the eyeball is shortened due to the shortness of eyeball. Due to the shortening of eyeball, the shortness of eyeball or shortening of eyeball. And second, increasing the pupil length. In myopia, the focal length is decreased, but in hypermetropia, the focal length of eyeball is increased. The focal length of eyeball increased, or we can say, if the converting power of eye lens is decreased, if converting power is decreased, then refracted rays will be converged after the retina. They will converge after the retina. If the image comes behind the retina, then also it can't be carried by optic nerves due to the absence of light sensitive cells. Due to this reason, a person will suffer from hypermetropia. Next, how to correct the hypermetropia? That is correction. We can correct the defect hypermetropia by using convex lens with suitable power. It can be corrected by using convex lens with suitable power. When we use any convex lens, then hypermetropia will be corrected. We'll discuss now what will be the ray diagram for this hypermetropia, how the image comes in hypermetropia or in hypermetropic eye and corrected eye. This one is eye. It is the eye lens. Retina. When a parallel beam of light enters the eye, then they will converge behind the retina. It is hypermetropic eye. The diagram for hypermetropic eye, due to the shortening of eyeball or the increasing of focal length of this eye lens, both the refracted rays will converge behind this retina. Image comes here, but it can't transmit it to the brain. So, person suffering from this hypermetropia can't see the object present in front of the eye. Next, when it is corrected by using convex lens, here convex lens is here, it will parallel beam of light is coming. First, when it passes through the lens which is used, it will convert somehow. When it enters the eye lens, it again converts and the refracted rays will meet on the retina. Here, image is forming here. In this case, the person can see. It is corrected. since the image is forming on the retina, then the person can see the object which is present in front of it. It is corrected eye, it is hypermetropic eye. Next, we discuss about phrase value. Another word is presbyopia. Generally, it happens the person who is in old age, due to the weakening of ciliary muscles, the ciliary muscles will not expand or relax easily, by which the focal length of the eye lens will not be adjusted. That is called power of accommodation. This adjustment of focal length of eye lens is called power of accommodation. Due to this weakening of ciliary muscles in old age, the power of accommodation will not be happen. The person has weak power of accommodation. In that case, the person can neither see distant object clearly, nor can see nearby objects clearly. So to correct this defect, we use bifocal lenses. Bifocal lenses. This bifocal lens means it is used both concave lens as well as convex lens in the same side of the spectacles. We use two types of lenses. Concave and convex. Concave lens, convex lens. In the upper side it is used concave lens, in the lower side it is used convex lens. Such type of lens is called bifocal lenses. By using these bifocal lenses, the presbyopia defect, presbyopia will be corrected and the person can see clearly.